for giving us yet another day, a wonderful day, a rainy day that, mighty Father, we witness your blessings, mighty God. We want to thank you for this day that you have opened for us, that we may come to your sanctuary to give you thanks, mighty Father. This is the day, this is the place, we are the people that the Lord, we are going to rejoice and be happy together for thy blessing. Now bless us, O our Father. Bless the service as we start. Hasten those who have not arrived, mighty Father. Those who are tired because of the lame King of Kings, we are saying you open ways for them that we may start with together, we may continue together and be blessed together. Our prayer of faith, in Jesus' name we pray and believe.
Amen.
Amen. Our Psalms of today is coming from Psalm 100, verses 1 to 5. Psalm 100, 1 to 5. And I read, shout for joy, shout for joy to the Lord, all the earth. Worship the Lord with gladness. Come before him with joyful songs. Know that the Lord is God. It is he who made us, and we are his. We are his people, the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and praise his name. For the Lord is good, and his love endures forever. His faithfulness continues through all generation. Amen?
Amen?
That is the word of the Lord. Praise and worship, please.
Praise God, church. We are here to praise God. He's good. Wacha tumshangiria Yesu.
Shangiria Yesu anaweza.
Yesu anaweza. Yesu anaweza. Yesu anaweza.
Shangria Yesu anaweza.
Yesu anaweza. Yesu anaweza. Yesu anaweza.
Shangria Yesu anaweza.
Yesu anaweza. Yesu anaweza. Yesu anaweza.
Shangria Yesu anaponya.
Yesu anaponya. Yesu anaponya. Yesu anaponya.
Shangria Yesu wainua.
Yesu wainua, Yesu wainua, Yesu wainua.
Shangria Yesu wabariki,
Yesu wabariki, Yesu wabariki, Yesu wabariki.
Chezea Bwana chezea, 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 chezea Bwana chezea, sababu ni mwema.
Chezea Bwana chezea, 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 chezea Bwana chezea. Sababu yu mwema.
Chezea Bwana chezea. Chezea, chezea. Chezea Bwana chezea. Sababu ni mwema.
Chezea Bwana chezea. Chezea, chezea. Chezea Bwana chezea. Sababu yu mwema.
Bariki Bwana bariki. Bariki, bariki. Bariki Bwana bariki. Sababu ni mwema.
Bariki Bwana bariki. Bariki, bariki. Bariki Bwana bariki. Sababu ni mwema.
Nitamwimbia Bwana kwa kuwa yeye ananiona. Imba.
Nitamwimbia Bwana kwa kuwa yeye ameniona. Yesu anaweza.
Shangria Yesu ni muweza.
Yesu ni muweza. Yesu ni muweza. Yesu ni muweza.
Shangria
Yesu anaponya, Yesu anaponya.
Changia Yesu wabariki,
Yesu wabariki, Yesu wabariki, Yesu wabariki.
Changia Yesu wabariki,
Yesu wabariki, Yesu wabariki, Yesu wabariki.
To your presence, past the gates of praise, into your sanctuary, where we're standing face to face. I look upon your countenance, I see the fullness of your grace. I can only bow down. Ninasema we Bwana, na ninakiri uwezo wako.
thank you for this day. We thank you for your goodness, Lord, in our lives. We worship you and we raise you up, O Jehovah God, because there is no one like you, O Jehovah God. Father, the person who sees into our hearts, O Lord God, you are our God. You are our Father. You are our friend, Jehovah God. Father, we come to you, O Lord God, telling you that you're great, O Jehovah God, that you've delivered us from very many things, O Jehovah God. I know, Lord God, even as we woke up this morning, O Jehovah God, you are with us. You brought us together to worship you and to praise you, O Jehovah God. Father, I thank you for this country of Kenya. And I thank you, Jehovah God, because you created this nation, O Jehovah God. You created the leadership in this nation, Jehovah God. You created the citizens in this country, Jehovah God. Father, I pray, O Jehovah God, that your spirit may come down, Jehovah God, that your spirit will come upon every person in this country, Jehovah God, that, Father, we are not going to live a life of fighting against each other, O Lord God, that, Father, we'll become brother to brother, sister to sister, O Lord God, not tribe versus tribe, O Lord God, because, Father, you created us as one, O Lord God. Father, I thank you for this church, O Jehovah God. Father, I thank you from the Secretary General, Jehovah God, all the way down to the deacons, O Jehovah God. I pray that, Lord God, you may continue being with them, O Jehovah God. Give them the strength to raise this church, O Jehovah God. Give them the continued strength, O Jehovah God, to work for us, O Jehovah God. Sometimes, oh Lord God, we do not know what they do in the background, oh Lord God. But Father, we pray that you may continue to bless them, oh Jehovah God. Father, I thank you for all the families that are represented in this congregation. Jehovah God, I pray for your cover upon everybody in this congregation, Jehovah God, that, Father, no one will say they are sick, O Jehovah God. No one will have anything that is going to be ailing them, even after they leave this place, Lord God, because, Lord God, you'll have come down, you'll have come and healed this person, O Jehovah God, because, Father, we know that, Father, you love us, O Jehovah God. Father, we pray for the sermon this day, O Lord God. Father, we know that, Lord God, the word that you're bringing to us this day is a word that only comes from you, Jehovah God. We thank you, Jehovah God. And we pray, Lord God, that, Father, we will listen and we will understand what you're sending to us, O Lord God. We praise you and we worship you, Jehovah God. Father, we just worship you, Lord God. We praise you, Lord God. We praise you for our youth, O Lord God. And Father, we pray all the confusion that is going around the world, O Lord God, targeting our youth, O God, that, Father, in the name of Jesus, Father, it is cast away. Father, thank you so much, because we know, Lord God, you're worthy, O Lord God. And Father, when you say something, O Lord God, it cannot be denied by anybody. We thank you and we bless you. In Jesus' name I pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you, praise and worship, and though taking us through the prayers, Lynn, now we will stand up and sing hymn number 737, Immortal, Invisible, God Only Wise. Let's be upstanding as the choir read us. 737.
I'm giving you my house.
Immortal, invisible, God only wise, in light inaccessible, He from our eyes, most blessed. Like greatness.
As they come to minister. You have a presentation, Nani, Michelle? Okay. Quickly, quickly, quickly.
Good morning, church.
No, wait for the others. Thank you, the warida is first. Quickly, thank you.
Good morning, church. In front of you is PCEA Kileleshwa Sunday School, ready to present a memory verse and a song. Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 8, it says, Do that which is right and good in the sight of the Lord. An angel came from heaven and rolled the stone away. An angel came from heaven and rolled the stone away. An angel came from heaven and rolled the stone away. And his Lord shall bear his children home. And he rose from the dead.
Hey, my friends, how are you?
Fine.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Yes, I can see you are well and you are set to fight against the baridi. Huh? Are you warm?
Yes.
Yes, because you are well protected. Even my friend here. Yes. My name is Reverend Anania. Who can repeat that?
Yes, here.
Reverend who?
Reverend Anania.
Anania. Yes. Yeah, it is a name which is unique. There are not many around here. And I love children. You are all my friends. And you have sung a good song which I like. You said, he rose from the dead. And somebody has seen him rising from the dead. Or some people went to see him and found the tomb is empty, or the angel had rolled the stone away. So they know Jesus is alive. How many know that Jesus is alive? Yes, even me, I know that. Because he did so many things in my life. So if he is alive, then we can pray to him. Ask him whatever we want. Sisawa, we tell our parent, I need this. Sometimes the small ones, they just cry. And the parents have to guess what they want. But I can see those who are grown up, you can ask exactly what you want from the parent. Sisawa. And other times, then when you are more than one in the house, and you are two, you are three, and then something is messed up somewhere. Kunamutu amefanya maovu somewhere. And the parent asks, who did this? And then it is not easy to say, I did it, forgive me. You say, it is not me, so and so. Have you seen that happen? Hmm? Yes, those who are more than one in the house. Are you ready to own up what you have done, which is not correct? That is what is a right living. And for us to live an honest life, a right living, we have to be truthful. Today we will learn about somebody they call a witness. A witness is somebody who is speaking about, talking about something he or she is sure he has seen it to happen. You don't lie, you don't guess, you don't say, maybe it was so and so who has done it, unless you have seen this person doing it. Okay? And if you haven't seen the person, and if it is you who has done it, you own up. You confess, you ask, you excuse yourself, ask the parent to forgive you, or mwalimu, whatever. Okay? That is now to live right and to be truthful. And a witness is somebody who has to speak the truth. Otherwise, you will not be a good friend of Jesus. And all of us want to be good friend of Jesus, isn't it? How many want to be good friend of Jesus? Yeah, then behave. Speak the truth and own up the mistakes. Ask forgiveness from the parent and the teachers when you have done something wrong. But to avoid to do something wrong, you just say the truth and be kind, obedient, and hard work in your classes. Follow what the teacher is saying and follow what the parent gives you as an instruction. It is for your benefit. Okay? We are good friends still? Are we? Good. So I want to pray with us, and then after that, we will ask one to guide us into doing the creed, the Apostles' Creed. Yeah? Who will do it for us? You did it in the first one. Eh? She's not the one. Oh, she looks like the one. All right. Yeah, you will do it. So let us pray. Thank you, Lord, for being together with us this morning, a Sunday, just after Easter, when we were taught that you died for our sins and you rose again. You are alive and together with us. Even now, you allowed us to come to worship you together with our children. We thank you that they are still obedient. They come and they listen to the lessons that they can grasp at their age. We pray special blessings upon them, that they continue to grow in this aspect, this disposition of heart, ready to listen to you, to listen to their parent, to listen to the Holy Spirit, ministering to them, even guiding them in their choices of friends, choices of what they will do or who they will be in the future when they grow up. So we pray that you guide them, you watch over them, and you bless them, protect them in a special way from any interference of the evil one in their plans, in their dreams, in their growing up, so that they grow to become witnesses of Jesus who is alive, who is active, who responds to our prayers, who intervenes in every aspect of our life, including forgiving our sins. So bless them, O dear Lord, and bless us all together. Continue guiding the teachers, the parents, all those who will intervene in their lives as they grow up, to impact them with good direction, especially the knowledge of God and Jesus Christ. We thank you, we honor you for this, our prophet, in Jesus' holy name. Amen. Amen. So now go ahead, guide us. And the parent, you rise. Go ahead.
I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Do you know the Lord's Prayer? Okay, start it.
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Amen. You appreciate this girl. Yes. God bless you. Keep it up.
Now we have the teens and the youth. Please come in front, teens and the youth. I know they have a presentation. Okay, I could see them. They don't, but here they are. Oh, 18 to 35. And the other, the young one, the teens.
You have a presentation. Any volunteer? So that the parent can see. You saw in the kids group, one is volunteering. Or I will give you a test. So that you remember me next time when I come, you will be ready. Okay. My friend, give us a chorus. Any.
Okay. Alpha, Omega, you are worthy of our praises today. Alpha, Omega.
Cover that talent. Next time we see you there. You have seen her? Go for her, recruit her. And a bass. Yes. She doesn't have to come alone. She has to be accompanied by a bass somewhere. Okay, my friends. Are you born again? Who is born again? Everyone. Yeah, maybe one or two. Okay. Someone has a testimony. A volunteer? Good. Okay, you read us in the service. All right, okay. I am not continuing to do the exams, but today we will learn about our witness. And you don't have to be shy to witness about Jesus Christ. That is the mission for which we are here, alive, strong, with opportunities. And the priority in our lives is to be a Christian. And a Christian is a witness. You understand? A Christian is a witness. A witness of who? Of Jesus Christ. So he has to have done something for you. You have to identify what he did for you and witness about it. Maybe another youth is struggling in that area and you can help him or her. Don't keep quiet if you know Jesus. Okay? Let you not be carried away by the other influences, because you are stronger than those others, because you have Christ in you, isn't it? Yeah. Thank you for being there, especially my daughter there. Thank you for that talent. And though you didn't volunteer, I volunteered you. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we want to thank you so very much for the gift of life. These young people, you know each one of them by name. You are the one who brought them this far. There are many of the same ages who have fallen by sideways along the journey. They have gone through primaries, secondaries, maybe universities. Some of them are on jobs. Others are still looking. This is the age where they have to make decisions for their lives, to dream dreams, big ones, what they want to be in life. They can't make it on their own. They need your guidance. They need your supply in terms of opportunities, opening doors for them, and making them to be a blessing to their neighbors, their peers, their friends, instead of being the target of the negative forces, because they all declared they know you. And they are here in your sanctuary, dear Lord. We pray special blessings upon them. Accept each one of them, even as they pray in their heart, what their heart desires are in your presence. The risen Christ, living conqueror, dear Lord, one who is above all, King of kings, Lord of lords. Nothing is beyond your power, the supreme power, the only one we run to, and we are, our issues are addressed sufficiently. So take charge of their lives, each one of them individually. Accept to guide them and to walk this journey of life together with them and make it successful to your glory and honor. And when they succeed, keep them humble. Let them acknowledge that it is you who did it, and they be true witnesses as our predecessors have been. We thank you. We honor you. This is our prayer of faith. In Jesus' holy name, amen. God bless you so much.
Thank you, Reverend, for pointing us, pointing the youth to the way. Koge, before you go, can you please give me the name of that lady who's led us in the praise and worship? Just walk around the congregation, get me the number. Thank you very much, members. This is very good. I stand here not at as Elder Mary, but as Elder Njao, who is our chair. She's not in today. She is attending an ordination of her cousin, who is becoming a minister. So she's not just relying somewhere because of the cold. she's still in the vineyard. So please know that she's somewhere, and I also want to greet you in the name of the Lord. Good morning. Good morning. How are you? Yes, you made a wise decision. I know it was cold. You would have chosen to stay at home. I also felt like I would want to stay at home. But I know that rain is what we have been praying for. This cold is what we have been praying for. If we are blessed, do we just sit down and enjoy the blessings? No, we come to give thanks and to praise him. You have made a very wise decision, and thank you for coming. Let's continue in this vineyard. We are yet to reach there. I know you are not comfortable. Are you very comfortable? The cold, especially those who are in the first service, it was very cold. How do you want to make it better? I know you have the decision. You have the right answer. Let's bring it forward that we can make ourselves more comfortable in this sanctuary. Thank you. Our registrar is ready to come and give us intimation. He doesn't have to welcome you. But on his behalf, let me also say ask so that he doesn't repeat. Do we have new members today? Because you remember from Gatondo Close, we have never had visitors. We only have members. Do we have anybody who is visiting us for the first time today? Please be upstanding. We appreciate you. Oh, we are all here ourselves. Do we have? No. Let's welcome one another. There's a welcome here. There's a welcome. Look at each other. Look at each other. Oh, yes.
Welcome here.
Yeah, there's a welcome here. Sing like you mean it. There's a Christian welcome here. On Mr. Wanjohi, please.
Thank you very much, Elda, for doing that bit. When the Elda welcomes you, mine is to take you direct to the intimation for this morning. Thank you, my Elda. I come from her district, Imani District. Now, the other intimation that we have this morning is that we have quite a few announcements on fellowships. One, the PCMF will have their monthly physical fellowship today at 3 p.m. right here in the church. The other one is that Bethlehem District will have a physical fellowship here at the church next Sunday at 3 p.m. The deacons will have their monthly fellowship through Zoom on Friday, 21st April at 7:30 p.m. The Finance Committee will have a physical meeting here on Saturday, 22nd April at 9 a.m. right here at the church. So note your group, wherever you are, and make arrangement to attend. We are very grateful when we see you attending. There are so many of you this morning. There are just almost as many during the first service. Now, continuing with the intimation, you might have noticed in the congregation wall that we advertise for two vacancies. One is for a youth and a children coordinator. The qualification are indicated there about that vacancy, and the duties to be done. If you feel you qualify for that post, you can apply. Or even if you don't qualify, if you know somebody who you feel can do that job, you can contact them. We would like to see them. There is also another vacancy advertised there of a music trainer. Again, the same thing. If you know somebody or if you feel you qualify for it, please apply. The music trainer is part-time, the coordinator is full-time. What is left for me now is that I have this document here. It is a communication from GAC to all the congregation of the Presbyterian Church. I won't read all of it. I'll just give you the summary of what is being communicated to you. As I told you, the message is from the Second General Administrative Committee of the 23rd General Assembly. The meeting was held at Bantu Africa Resort in Nyeri County in Kiganjo Presbytery. The group was composed of 146 commissioners and 59 presbyteries. The meeting was on 14th of April 2023. They said greetings to all of you. The other item is appreciation. The GAC was appreciative that members remained steadfast and selfless in their support of the church. Continue supporting the church. The group also wants to communicate to you that they have made a lot of achievements. Just to highlight a few, the church institutions have been growing and discharging their mandate. The church is also very active in many ways. For example, we did some celebration. We celebrated the 100 years of Women's Guild. We also celebrated the 40 years of women ordination and many others that were indicated. They also ordained a lot of ministers, evangelists were trained, and many elders have been ordained. The church has indeed been very active. Stewardship of resources. GAC urges all leaders and the members to be good stewards of what is entrusted to them. The other issue is environmental stewardship. The church supports the initiative to plant 100 million trees, particularly that the church has signed an MOU with KEFRI that they would meet that obligation. You individually can purpose to do that. On LGBTQ, PCEA is against the Supreme Court ruling in favor of the above group. I think that tells it all. Education. The church supports church-owned and church-sponsored educational institutions. On family, the church urges all members to uphold family values. That is honesty, faithfulness, hard work, love, forgiveness, and a peaceful interpersonal relationship. State of Nations, the church thanks God that he had held our country together, particularly our country Kenya, in spite of the obstacles or problems or challenges that have been there, like drought, budgetary, cost of living, demonstrations, and you know the demonstration which were held recently, our church was burnt and the school in Kibera. So that is the communication, and in conclusion, it says that our prayer from each one and all of us is to be found acceptable at the end of our lives, remembering that much as we are justified and sanctified in this life, we will only be glorified after our labors on this earth. We must invest more in the permanent rather than in temporary or temporal. As a church, we must not lose our flavor as the salt of the earth, or dim our light as the light of the world. That is according to Matthew chapter 5, verse 13 to 14. We must continue to be careful and thoughtful in our ways. May our God bless us all. Signed by Right Reverend Thego Mutahi, moderator of 23rd General Assembly, and Reverend Dr. Robert Waihenya, Secretary General, signed on 14th April 2023. And at this juncture, I'll call Mr. Wamai to come and give intimation on fundraising, and after that, we'll have Jabi.
Thank you. Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Indeed, this is the day that the Lord has made. Once again, I want to remind you that we are approaching very fast the day of our fundraising, which is 26th of June, 2023. In that effort, as I said earlier, the activation or the concentration of the effort is at the district level. And therefore, we have the pledge cards that are laid at the district level. They are with the district champions. Imani, the district champion, is Mr. Efantas. In Jerusalem, Mr. Hezron. And in Bethlehem is Mr. Mudhiola. Today, cards are available at our registration tent. So if you'd want to get your card, you can get your card at the registration desk. We are also aware that there are some persons who do not patronize districts. And therefore, we have created a fourth district, which is headed by Dr. Kinuthi Amwangi, and it is operating also at the registration tent. If you don't belong to any district, although it's a prayer that everybody registers with a district, if you don't belong to any district, please make sure that you pick your pledge card at the registration desk. Also, for visitors, those who may be visiting for only today, and you'd want to bless this church with a donation, you can also visit the registration desk and see somebody at the fourth district. Please continue praying for the fundraising, and because we only give what God has given us, so pray that God continues to give us something so that we may bring it to his house. On the issue of guests of honor, elders will be requesting for guests of honors at the district level. So please feel very encouraged to volunteer to be a guest of honor for our fundraising on the 26th. As the theme of this fundraising says, it is not by might nor by power, but by the Holy Spirit, says the Lord. That is from Zechariah 4:6. God bless you as you continue to pray and to prepare for the fundraising. God bless you.
Praise God, church. My name is Esther Njambi. I stand before you as the chair of the youth and invite each and every one of you to join us as we celebrate the Youth Week that will begin from tomorrow all the way to Sunday next week. For this week, we have prepared various activities that we'll take part in. For Monday, we'll have a talk with the TE committee where we'll be given a talk on drug and substance abuse and how it is affecting the youth. On Tuesday, we'll have a day of prayers for the youth and the nation, where the youth will join together in their various homes to pray for these issues that are affecting us. On Wednesday, we'll have a Bible study where the youth will join again online to discuss various scriptures in the Bible. On Thursday, we'll have a talk with the Thanksgiving Committee where they will talk to us about careers, and we'll have various panelists who will discuss various issues regarding careers, either how to advance in our careers, how to cope with the various different changes that are affecting us, and even we'll have a psychiatrist who'll give us a talk on issues, the negative parts of career, such as the lack of work and such issues regarding careers. And on Friday, we'll have a movie night where we'll meet at Kenya High School to watch a movie. And on Saturday, we'll all join together where we will go to Karura, where we'll have various activities planned there. There'll be bike riding, there'll be tennis playing, there'll be a lot of activities. And I invite each and every one of you, no matter what age, whatever whether you feel you're too old or too young, this is all activities that are doomed, that are gained to help each and every one of us. So let us support the youth, and also I urge the youth to step up and take part in these various roles, even as we continue to praise and honor the name of the Lord. Thank you.
All those youth can come back. Or you just stand where you are. I hope you are the ones who will be participating. Though the invitation is for all of us, maybe the Zoom one. And the fun on Friday, we are also invited. it's all right. Okay, I hear the theme is from Romans 1:16. Okay, that will be the base of your Bible study. Right, and it says, for I am not ashamed of the gospel, because it is the power of God that brings salvation to everyone who believes, first to the Jew, then to the Gentile. Yeah. We are the Gentile, all of us. Hakuna Jew here. So, but the grace of God has extended to us also. And he says, I'm not ashamed of the gospel. And it is really a great theme you have chosen. So, as you will study about it, you reflect, and you understand the content of the gospel and what the gospel is sent out to do in our lives, to transform our lives into new beings, servant of Jesus Christ, witnesses of his victory. So you have been living it, now you will increase because we have more knowledge about it. Okay? So let us pray. Gracious Lord, we want to thank you so very much for our youth in the church, the whole church, PCEA. They will have their Youth Sunday, Youth Week, and this particular chapter, they have scheduled activities. From tomorrow onward to Sunday they will lead services all through the church. Dear Lord, we want to commit these youth, we want to commit all those participants, and especially these ones where we are, dear Lord, that you will avail as many or all of them part of this congregation, and also you will impact their lives in all those activities that are scheduled, that you will guide them, you will protect them, you will inspire them. At the end of the whole week, they will have moved another step higher, closer to fulfilling your purpose in their lives, each one of them. So guide them, inspire them, and bless them. Make it successful to your glory and honor. This is our prayer of faith in Jesus' holy name. Amen. Now, on behalf of your chaplain, who is my successor in the French congregation, Reverend Tolno, and with the authority given by the church, the Congregation of St. Andrews, I declare this Youth Week in this congregation launched to the glory of God. Amen. Amen.
I have seen so many youth who are not standing to come here, not standing to be launched. I don't know whether they have already grown old, but in the next life I'll be a youth. However, this is the time for presentation. But now that we have been decided, we're going district way, let me see whether I have Imani in this congregation. Let's be upstanding, Imani. And all those who live, Kerereshwa, Huko Westlands, Riverside, all those, You are Imani. All those are good. We are not, even the cameraman is Imani. So take a card as you go. Thank you very much. We have been given a duty. You may have your seats. Let's take a card. Choir, please give your presentation.
Christ is risen.
Mm-hmm.
So 3, 2, 1, which go.
Up from the grave he arose, with the mighty triumph of his foes. He arose a victor from the dark domain, and he lives forever with his saints to reign. He arose, hallelujah, Christ arose.
He arose, hallelujah,
the grave. He arose, he arose. Now we go to the Bible readings. The Bible readings, which is coming from, the first reading comes from John 20, 1 to 10, read by Njeri Geshura. Please come forward. And the second reading is John 20, 11 to 18, read by Sisiri Magati. Please follow, stand behind her as you read consecutively. Thank you. God bless.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
First reading from the book of John, chapter 20, verse 1 to 10. Angela Njeri Geshura is my name. I'll be reading you today. Early on the first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene went to the tomb and saw that the stone had been removed from the entrance. So she came running to Simon Peter and the other disciple, the one Jesus loved, and said, "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and we don't know where they have put him." So Peter and the other disciples started for the tomb. Both were running, but the other disciple outran Peter and reached the tomb first. He bent over and looked in at the stripes of linen lying there, but did not go in. Then Simon Peter came along behind him and went straight into the tomb. He saw the stripes of linen lying there, as well as the cloth that had been wrapped around Jesus' head. The cloth was still lying in its place, separate from the linen. Finally, the other disciple who had reached the tomb first also went inside. He saw and believed. They still did not understand from Scripture that Jesus had to rise from the dead. Then the disciples went back to where they were staying. That's the reading of the day.
I'll continue from where she has left. We continue with the book of John 20, 11 to 18. Now Mary stood outside the tomb crying, and she wept. She bent over, looked into the tomb, and saw two angels in white, seated where Jesus' body had been, one at the head and the other at the foot. They asked her, "Woman, why are you crying?" "They have taken my Lord away," she said. "I do not know where they have put him." At this, she turned round and saw Jesus standing there, but she did not realize that it was Jesus. He asked her, "Woman, why are you crying? Who is it you are looking for?" Thinking he was the gardener, she said, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have put him, and I will get him." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned towards him and cried out in Aramaic, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said, "Do not hold on to me, for I have not yet ascended to the Father. Go instead to my brothers and tell them, I am ascending to my Father and your Father, my God, to my God and to your God." Mary Magdalene went to the disciples with the news, "I have seen the Lord," and she told them that he had said these things to her. That's the word of the Lord.
Let's all be upstanding and sing hymn number as we call our very own minister, Reverend Anani Dwamungu, who is our parish minister. He could be retired, but he still be one of us. He's not tired yet. Hymn number 297, standing on the promises of God.
Standing on the promises of Christ my King, through eternal ages let his praises ring. Glory in the highest, I will shout and sing. Standing on the promises of God, standing, standing, standing on the promises of God my Savior. Standing on the promises of God, standing on the promises.
promises of God, my Savior, standing, standing. I'm standing on the promises of God, standing on the promises I now can see. Perfect present cleansing in the blood for me, standing in the liberty where Christ made free. Standing on the promises of God, standing, standing, standing on the promises of God, my Savior, standing, standing. I'm standing on the promises of God, standing on the promises of Christ alone. Bound to Him eternally by love's strong core, overcoming daily with the Spirit's word. Standing on the promises of God, standing, standing, standing on the promises of God, my Savior. Standing on the promises of God, standing on the promises I cannot fail. Listening every moment to the Spirit God, resting in my Savior as my all in all. Standing on the promises of God, standing, standing, standing on the promises of God.
You promise that you are together with us till the end of the world, that we should be going and bearing witnesses, discipling people, teaching them, baptizing them, bearing fruit for them to emulate. Dear Lord, as you go, as you send us, you promised you will go with us. We have come to worship you. We have come also to listen from you. Speak to our hearts, speak to our concerns, speak to our issues, and give us a direction so that, dear Lord, we know we are bearing witness of the living conqueror, Jesus, who rose from the dead, is alive and active in our lives. Speak, we are listening. This is our prophet in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. May be seated. And I want to greet you all in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Yes, the members of the congregation, you know me, I am one of the ministers in St. Andrews, a young retired one, and always recycled, because the strength of the Lord, that is my great joy to serve indeed. And as usual, Makena is around, we came together. And she has changed her sitting. She is now at the tent. Yes, and our daughter sends greetings. She's in the country, the other side, in Kigali. And she went to visit other people and reconnect. She has finished her university, so now she's just touring around. I am so happy to come again in this year, I think third time, and that means we have you at heart, and whenever we come, we see an increase in numbers, and we thank God. Today was especially cold. It rained heavily in Machakos when we came. We had to put lights on and hazard so that other cars can see us. And we managed to be here on time, and we thank God. It is always Him who opens the way. So today we are talking about witnessing. And the greatest witness is to witness about Jesus Christ, who is alive and active, the risen Christ. It is where our Christian faith is based. If Christ had not risen, our faith would be built on a ground that is sinking. And Paul himself has said that in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, he said, from verse 12 of chapter 15 to 23rd, I just pick verse 14, 15, and 19, 20 to 21. If Christ had not been raised, our preaching is useless, and so is your faith. More than that, we are then found to be false witnesses about God, for we have testified about God that He raised Christ from the dead. Verse 19, if only for this life we have hope in Christ, we are of all people most to be pitied. But Christ has indeed been raised from the dead, the first fruit of those who have fallen asleep. For since death came through a man, the resurrection of the dead comes also through a man, and that is Jesus Christ. And I was checking on the word witness. It is defined as, the word witness is said about one who may be called to testify to an event at which he, she was present. It is an eyewitness. You have to speak the truth of what you have seen, not what you heard about or a rumor. You have to be sure, I saw it happen. And there are many witnesses in the Bible, very many. And he categorized them. In the Old Testament even, they say things, object, can also be witnesses. And they give two examples, many examples, but I chose just two. In Genesis chapter 31, verse 45 to 49, the covenant between Jacob and Laban. When Jacob had finished his term of service, he was already married to two daughters of Laban, and he had many sons already, and cattle, big one, a big cattle. He was just returning under the instruction of God. Now you can go back to serve me in the land. And Laban followed him and caught up with him because one of the daughters had stolen his gods. And he was to check, you stole my daughters, you didn't even allow me to say kwaheri kwao, goodbye to them. And beside that, why have you stolen my gods? Jacob didn't need those gods because he had a god. He had God. So it was only one of the daughters. And even Laban checked in. He found nothing because she cheated still. You know the story. So finally, finding nothing to reproach his son-in-law, he said, we covenant now. And they erected a pile of stones, and they said, this heap of stone will be forever a witness between me and you, that no one will cross over this way or that way to harm the other. So it was a covenant of peace, witnessed by stones. And also Isaiah 19, verse 19 to 20, there is an altar in the land of Egypt and a monument that was erected there so that it be a witness to the Lord, to their God, the Israelites who had gone, the sons of Jacob. They went, 70 of them, but they multiplied there, they became a nation, and then Egyptians feared them and they started making them slaves. So when they cry to God for rescue, God will remember the witness that is there. His people are there and he will send a savior to them. So an altar, a monument, are witnesses. God himself is a witness. As Laban and Jacob said, God will be our witness and this heap. That is Genesis 31, verse 50. Job said, God is my witness. Jeremiah, and in Acts, the disciples, the 11, because Jesus was talking to 11, you will be my witnesses. References, Job 16, 19, Jeremiah 29, 23, and 42, verse 5, and Acts chapter 1, verse 9. All peoples, many, but here, in the culture of the Jewish people, it was men standing where they were to settle issues. At the exit of Joshua, chapter 24, after all the journeys and all the things he had done, distributing the allotment to different tribes to the, of the land of promise, then he's aging, and he gathered all the Israelites, and because they had started imitating the worship to Baals and other Ashtaroth, they found the Canaanites worshiping. And they say, decide now whom to follow, whom to worship, either God, whom you know, or those idols. But as for me, I'll serve, me and my house will serve the Lord. Verse 22 of chapter 24, the people said, we will serve the Lord. And he went on educating them that it is not that easy. It is a decision they are making of themselves. But if they fail in their commitment, they will see what God will do to them. So, men acknowledge that they are witnesses. Another instance is in Ruth chapter 4, verse 9 to 11. You know Naomi, you know Ruth, and the other girl. They became widows. Then Naomi decided to go back, and Ruth clinked on her and said, I will not leave you. I will go with you. When they reached the land, then Naomi had to care for Ruth to get a husband, and Boaz akajitokerezea. He was a relative to rescue the case. But there was somebody else who had the right before him. So it has to be witnessed by the elders, the men at the gate, and as a sign, the one who has first right has to remove a shoe and give it to the next of kin. And that is another witness. And the men there are witnesses. So, witnessing of something, a transition, an event, something you are sure and it is legal, it is right, it is in the culture, it is given as a duty we have to do, all those aspects of witnessing. God himself, he called his people Israelite as his witnesses. Because of the way he chose them, from the time he called Abraham in Genesis 12, and they constituted a nation, when they were slaves, when they were set free, all that the Lord has done through Moses and Joshua, and then the other kings. And he says in Isaiah 43, verse 10 and 12, you, my people, you are witnesses that there is no other God except me. There is none else anywhere. Others are idols, timber, wood, manufactured by people's hands. But me, I dealt with you, I dealt with your enemies as mighty, as God who decides and operates and promises and realizes my promises. There is none else. He used to instruct them, then worship me. Worship the Lord. Love the Lord with all your heart, mind, strength, and obviously love your neighbors, yourself, that is in the New Testament. The apostles, the 12, they were still 11, they acknowledged themselves as witnesses before the replacement of Judas Iscariot by Matthias. In Luke 24:46-48, where Jesus commissioned them, and Acts 1:8, Acts 2:32, 3:15, and 5:32. All those are references you can check, and you will find that God instruct or install you as a witness. And there are many who have been witnesses, starting by John the Baptist, who came to announce that the Messiah is just at the door. He is coming behind him in John chapter 1, many verses there. Jesus Christ himself came and was a witness of God's plan for his people, even the other nations that will join in the system of salvation that he came to accomplish. Even the detractors of Jesus, Pilate put an inscription on the cross acknowledging that this Jesus is a king, King of the Jew. He's a witness because he interviewed him, prosecuting him. They were accusers of falsehood. Jesus didn't even defend him, but only he told him, if I wanted to compete for kingdom here, my people could have fought. My kingdom is not of this earth. My kingdom is of heaven. And Pilate then said, you see, this man is innocent. He's not my competitor. I release him. I say, no. Okay, whom do you choose? Barabbas. Okay, get him. And the other one I do? Crucify him. So I don't know how Pilate will be judged. In our law court, he can be innocent. But that is for God to decide. He was not courageous enough to face injustices and just stand for the truth. He didn't know the truth, by the way. He asked, what is the truth? When Jesus invited him, whoever stands for the truth, listen to my voice. Others are those beneficiaries of the miracles that Jesus did. A man born blind, John 9:39, and also in John 15:26-27, the Holy Spirit will witness. When he comes, he will witness about me, because Jesus was about to ascend, and the role of the Holy Spirit will be to remind the disciples and the generations afterward, ourselves today, of what Jesus did and taught and the purpose of his ministry and mission. There are Peter, there are James, there are Paul, who was previously Saul, and him it was dramatic when he was intercepted on the road to Damascus, and Jesus appeared to him, spoke to him. So many of the witnesses, they witness about what they saw and what they had from the authority of God. The Jewish people, they didn't see God because no one can see him and live, but they saw the crowd, the witness again, the crowds, the pillar of fire, the splitting of the sea and the cross, miracles, the getting of water in the desert from a rock, all those things. They received the Ten Commandments from the hands of Moses, who had ascended, and God wrote those testimonies, and so on and so forth. Now we are talking about a risen Christ, a human who lived among us, and witnesses, eyewitnesses, saw him living, walking, teaching, doing miracles, and the courageous ones, very few, they saw him at the cross. And they saw him being led in the tomb as a dead person. Among those, there is one particular person, Mary of Magdala, Mary Magdalene. John, as well as the other three gospel writers, they explain the resurrection in a bit of details, and some they put just 2-3 verses. But John has concentrated a longer portion of the writing on this lady, Mary Magdalene, for a purpose, for sure, because he is bringing her in front, in the far front rank, before the 12. Yes, we were told the event of Friday that Jesus was crucified, and we have seen Peter denying him. He vanished after Judas betrayed him. And it remained 10. Where are they? At the cross, there was only John and Mary. Mary Magdala, Mary, mother to James and the others, and Salome somewhere. I don't know those two disciples to Emmaus, if they were around, because they will be number two witnesses. But Mary Magdala, since the time Jesus casted out 7 demons from her, as we are told in In Luke 8, verse 2, She was in Galilee, and all the other ladies, they are Galileans. Everybody was around. It is where Jesus was ministering. And when she was rescued from that slavery of demon possession, she clinged on Jesus. She joined the group of ladies to assist, to minister to Jesus and the 12 wherever they went, from village to cities. And it is said in Mark 15, verse 40 to 41, and also in Luke 8, verse 3. So they were volunteers, servant of this group ministering together with Jesus. As they were assisting with just whatever they had, maybe they have been business people, I don't know, they say they supported the ministry of Jesus and his disciples out of their own means. They were supplying, they were serving, fetching water, cooking food. So if they were permanently there, that means they learned, they witnessed all the lessons, all the miracles. They knew Jesus equally at the rank of the 12. Except few instances when Jesus goes secluded with the 12, or sometimes with three only among the 12, and so on. You know the Bible. So this lady comes prominently because on Friday they didn't have opportunity to minister to Jesus' body, to embalm the body so that it is conserved and it rests in the tomb. So they were coming to finish the duties, the earthly duties to Jesus with them physically, and conclude the chapter. Surprise. She gets there. Other gospel, they say they came two or three. But John is concentrating on this one. She came with the things, surprised. The tomb is open and empty. So she came back to Peter and John to tell them they have taken away the Lord. You know, she identified Jesus as my Lord. And then they came back to check. They found the situation the same. Probably they went back, puzzled, not knowing what to do. What did Magdalene do? She just sat there, crying. Now she doesn't know what to do. I need my Lord. Alive or dead? And then Jesus mercifully just sent the angels. She checked again. She saw two angels. She had not seen them before. And then they asked her, "Woman, what are you looking for here?" And she complained, "They have taken my Lord away, and I don't know where they have put him." They, who? I don't know. They don't say. When she came, the soldiers were still around. Maybe they had taken off. Another gospel say, actually, when she approached, there was a shaking of an earthquake, and the soldiers fell like dead. And she saw an angel rolling the stone and then sitting on it and addressing her. Jesus obviously went directly, didn't show himself before that. But here we are told they gave her information. He's not here. He rose again. He had been telling you that. Still perplexed, she just turned and saw now Jesus. Jesus is so gracious. When he sees you are searching to meet him, when he sees you are earnest thirst to meet him, he comes. So he showed himself before ascending to the Father. He gives her priority. And she thought, this is the gardener. Sir, if you have taken him away, please show me the place and get him back. Imagine, she witnessed the putting of the body there, the rolling of stone, and even the guards to make sure no one takes him out. And she wants to fight this battle and get him. How strong she felt, how determined she wanted to see her Lord. And Jesus now opened up and said, Mary. That was enough. That communication, that link, that voice, she recognized immediately. She has been used to listening to this voice, teaching. This voice, sharing, love, healing people, teaching people. She didn't hesitate. She didn't see now the gardener anymore. This is Rabboni, my teacher. He's my Lord. He's my teacher. She was satisfied. And obviously she wanted to cling on him, and Jesus told her, okay, now that you know I am here, I am now going to show myself to the dad, and then I will come back. So then she was very happy, and she went. She was commissioned to go and tell the disciples now, Peter, John, who came after she informed them and went back. Now they are going to receive the information from one who is not among the 12, but who loved Jesus, who clinged to Jesus, for whom Jesus is number one in her life. She's the one commissioned to inform these others that I have seen the Lord. Amen? I have seen him. What kind of event, what kind of incident, what kind of something that connects you with Jesus that can attach you to him in that way that you discern his voice whenever he speaks? Have you valued your relationship with Jesus to that level when he says, here I am, I want you to do 1, 2, 3, I want to go you to go here and there, I want you to go and tell, to witness? Have you developed that relationship with Jesus to that level? There have been many, many, many witnesses, and Jesus appeared another 12 times before, within 40 days before his ascension. But the very, very important one, especially in terms of John's gospel, is the elevation of this lady to the rank of an apostle. Because she is the one who went to tell the apostles about the good news. So Jesus, what he banked on is your commitment, your personal openness to him, your personal earning to identify with him. As a deer pant for living waters, so my soul pant for you, O my Lord. And one of the Psalms. So the testimony of the first disciples. Concerning Jesus' resurrection, concerning his life, his death, his resurrection is the base of our faith. How do we take it in? At which level do we identify with it? Some of us may experience Jesus through a vision, through a dream, hearing his voice, or reading his word, and the Holy Spirit interprets for you. And in any experience, what matters is how you relate to this revelation of Jesus Christ to you. Our response to Jesus, our personal response to his personal revelation to individual, to me, to you as a person, not as a group, district, church, congregation, big church, universal church. He seeks you, he seeks me. So my response now is what determines the content of my testimony. My response to him is what will determine the content of my testimony. And it will give it weight so that people, when they hear, they don't doubt. Since the Lord Jesus rescued my life, actually, I changed the location. I went to work in another city, came back with my salvation and went to live the other side of the city. Because where I was living, I was staying around with my colleague at work. Some of them have been my schoolmate. And because I worked 2 years somewhere before joining where we were working together, I found them very advanced in this worldly life, residing in the city. So they inducted me in that life. 6 companions. There was a bar in the neighborhood with a table with 6 corners, hexagon. And when we enter, the occupant have to vacate. Otherwise, we will tell everybody who is there, we go to another bar and we will pay the beer for them. So the owner had to comply every evening. This is our place. You see where I was. And I grew to become their leader. So when I got born again, I understood being a new creation. 2 Corinthians 5:17. But I had to stay away so that when I confront them, I am strong. So I met them 2 years later. We were residing in the same city, different part. And from there, I grew very, very fast in the faith. To national leadership of Scripture Union, to many, many activities in the church, elder, commissioner of evangelism, anything, choir, prayer group, coordinator, Bible studies, coordinator, any group I attend, I am in the committee, everything. But when I talk about Jesus, I know what he did to my life. I know where he pulled me from. And I know because beyond that, he spoke to me. I heard his voice. I didn't see him in vision, but I heard his voice, his very voice. In circumstances, I have given testimonies about it in the pulpit. Those years in the 90s in Rwanda. And my friend, you have to have a position in the Lord Jesus. You have to know him in order to talk about him, to witness about him. Among all these witnesses, there is a group called the crowd of witnesses from Hebrew 12 that Peter is talking about. And all confessing Christians are in that crowd. But you have to have a specific testimony about Jesus. Yours. What has he done for you? What do you know about him that is particular, different from anybody else? That is what now brought Mary Magdalena to that level where God, Jesus, his teacher, her master, her Lord, elevated her to this level. We were expecting it is Peter who will receive the news, the first one. But he had failed the test. He had denied him. John was with Peter. But even him, they were still fearful together, though he took charge of Mary, mother to Jesus. So someone, somewhere, just Mary Magdalena comes to be number one receiving the news. So God can bring you to another level where you bear witness. He has a plan for you. He has a dream for you. Just connect with him, embrace him, see his vision, and then you will see what he will do with your life. And it is never late. So my friends, let me just conclude here. If you know Jesus as your teacher, the way Magdalene knew him, or a helper, or a guide, encourager, comforter, protector, provider, anything you need, he is all in all. There is nothing he can't address in your life whenever you need him. He's the one who called us in Matthew 11:28. Come to me, learn from me. I am humble. My burden is not heavy. Just learn from me. Join me. He said he's the way, the truth, and the life. He's the light of the world. He is the Alpha and Omega. He is the Good Shepherd. He is everything. What is he for you? Have you picked one or everything? Bearing witness has a missiological significance because it is the way of spreading awareness of the life-changing impact that Jesus effect in one's life, starting by the bearer of the testimony. When you communicate your testimony, somebody may be found in a similar situation as I told to the youth. And that person, he has found a solution. Let me try this. And then you have witnessed and a soul is saved. Don't keep quiet. That Jesus whom you know, he has called you, he has given you salvation free of charge, but he wants you to use that salvation to bear fruit. And the way of bearing fruit is to witness. A Christian, in the first place, is a witness. That's the first definition of a Christian, a witness of Jesus Christ. How to qualify? John 3:16, you know it, even Sunday school kids know it. God so loved the world that he gave his own son, Jesus Christ, that whoever believes in him, that is the qualification. Believe in his testimony. Believe in the testimonies about him. And believe in yourself if you have that testimony. And go out and spread that testimony. 1 Peter 2:9 and 10. As for you, you are a chosen people, a holy nation, God's own people, taken out of darkness into his marvelous light, so that you go out and spread the good news, what he has done for you. So it is not by just a hazard. You walk around, you hear they are praying here, you enter. No. Your parent brought you to church since you were a kid. I am among those who were brought to church, but I was baptized the same day with my dad and mom. We are a first generation of Christian in our home, in our clan. And it comes to a point where you have to commit your life to Jesus personally. Know him, accept him, and give your life to him. Let me conclude reading Colossians 1, 9 to 14. Just reading. Our connecting with Jesus Christ brings us our life to knowledge, to the knowledge of his will, through all the wisdom and understanding that the Spirit gives. The reason why? So that one may live a life worthy of the Lord, pleasing him in every way, bearing fruit in every good work, growing in the knowledge of God, and being strengthened with all power according to his might, glorious might. Once you get there, you will have great endurance and patience and giving joyful thanks to the Father who has qualified you to share in the inheritance of his holy people in the kingdom of light. He has prepared everything. Just connect with Jesus. And connect, never to release. He has rescued us from the dominion of darkness and brought us into the kingdom of his Son he loves, in whom we have redemption and forgiveness of sins. My friends, if you are connected with Jesus Christ, you are already rescued from the dominion of darkness. You are walking in the light. Fear nothing. You are part of the kingdom of Jesus Christ. You are redeemed, you are forgiven of all your sins. Then bring forth your testimony. Share it. Be at work. Serve the kingdom by testifying of what the Lord has done for you. Are you doing it? Yes. Good and well. If no, what is the problem? What is lacking? Courage, strength, determination, or love for your Savior and your Lord? Let us respond to Act 1:8, where it is said, when the Holy Spirit comes on you, you will be my witnesses. Whether you like it or not. Yeah. Let us ask God to send us the Holy Spirit that he sent the day of Pentecost to his disciples, and the fearful, the coward rose to be number one in the street preaching and confronting authorities, powers. They accepted to be persecuted and dead. And one of the persecutors, Saul of Tarsus, was confronted with the Lord Jesus. And he witnessed. He was now a 13th, number 13 of apostles. Judas had been replaced by Matthias. There is no other apostles. Those who hear around here, apostles, they don't qualify. I say it with authority. +1, Paul, because they saw Jesus. They witnessed about what they saw. Friends, may the Holy Spirit continue to minister to each one of us so that next time we find this tent full of witnesses, because we have witnessed. If everybody around you is a witness, good and well, starting from your home. But if there is one who doesn't have a testimony about Jesus yet, that is our mission. Let us rise. Dear Lord, we thank you for opportunities you give us to learn and continue to learn. We thank you for the gift of salvation. You paid it all. We are enjoying the fruit of your sacrifice. We are washed through the blood. We are cleansed. We are redeemed. We are forgiven. We are your children. We have a role to play. Empower us by your Holy Spirit so that, dear Lord, in our remaining years on this planet Earth, our testimonies be meaningful in the kingdom to bring others to the knowledge of Jesus and to bring others to find this privilege we are enjoying of being called children of God, living with hope that one day we will see face to face our Savior, our Redeemer, Jesus. We want to come with all the members of our families, all the members of our communities, our neighbors, enablers to bear witness as far as we can go. Enable us and open doors for that matter. We thank you, we honor you. This is our prayer of faith that we pray in Jesus' holy name. Amen. God bless you in every way.
It is a moment now to respond to that wonderful service with our tithe and offering. And I call Helen Wanjohi.
Good afternoon, church. I hope you're still here with us. Thank you very much, Reverend Anania. That was a wonderful preaching and sermon about being witnesses of God. So we have come to the part where we bless the Lord with our givings, and there are various ways that we can do that. The first one being cash. We have our deacons who are going round passing envelopes. If you have cash, you can call unto them. We also have a way of checks. We write our checks to PCEA Kileleshwa Church. And the third way is through M-Pesa. And I'll take you through the two bank accounts that we have. The first one being the development account, which is cooperative bank. So you open your Lipa na M-Pesa and type the pay bill, 400, 200, and the account number is 400, 55650. Let me repeat that. You open your Lipa na M-Pesa, this is the development account, cooperative bank, pay bill number 400, 200, account number is 400, 55650. We also have our operational account, Lipa na M-Pesa, pay bill number 247247. This is for Equity Bank. Account number being 141300. For specific orders, add a hashtag. For example, if you have a tithe, 141300, hashtag tithe. If you have an offering, 141300, hashtag offering. If you have Thanksgiving, 141300, hashtag Thanksgiving. The numbers are also stuck on the walls of the tent, the account numbers. You can look at them. Choir, you can give us a song as we wait for the deacons to finish. Before your hearts full of thanksgiving for the many things that you've done. Thank you for waking us up this morning and letting us see this beautiful day, Almighty God. Right now, dear Heavenly Father, we want to commit these offerings unto you, asking that you bless the pockets that have removed all these offerings, oh my God. And those who are not able to remove, oh dear Heavenly Father, May you give them double blessings, O dear Lord, so that next time and the other time they'll be able to remove, O dear Heavenly Father. We also ask that you continue giving us this blessing, these blessings, O dear Lord, that we may have something to give each and every Sunday, O dear Heavenly Father. And for that, we pray, trusting and believing. Amen.
Thank you, each one who has participated in this service, and our daughter who has been doing this service of adjusting the mic and so on. Yeah, and we really thank God for an opportunity to worship Him together. Let us pray as we conclude. Heavenly Father, we continue to commit to you our lives. You have spoken in a very understandable language, and we are here available. We are going to our various duties this day onward. We always expect your Holy Spirit to guide us in every move, in every action, in every decision. And wherever we will be, O dear Lord, whatever we will be doing, may your peace that passes our understanding always keep our hearts, our mind in the knowledge and love of you and our Savior and Lord Jesus Christ. And your blessing of Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be and remain with each and every one of us, with our loved ones in all situations of life, now and forevermore. Amen. Amen. Blessed Sunday. And there will be a sunshine, don't worry.
We have come to the end of the service. I thank you all for your patience. I know in the morning we delayed kidogo, but in God's time we have come to the end of it. My name is Elder Mary Mothoniwamogo, and Christ is Lord and Savior of my life. Coming from District Imani, which was serving today. And I welcome all of you to join Imani, because we are not many, so that we can meet what Mr. Wamai wants us to do. Let's go to hymn number 308, which will respond to the song as our final hymn, 308. To respond to the sermon. I am not ashamed to own my Lord. 308. I'm not ashamed to own my Lord, or to defend His cause. Maintain the honor of His word, the glory of His cross. On the cross where I first saw the light, and then pardon all my heart all the way. It was there by faith I received my son, and now I am happy all the day. Jesus, my God, I know His name. His name is all my trust. No weary put my soul to shame.